Hey everyone, I know I haven't posted anything in quite a while now, but the reason for that is actually that I've been pretty busy developing a new game with a few friends lately. And yeah, now it's finished, so I just wanted to quickly show you what we've made. The idea behind our game was basically to remake Snake, but in 3D and using ray tracing. Because the cool thing about ray tracing in this case is that it makes for a really nice visualization of the way the playing field kind of loops around itself. Because in the original game, if the snake leaves the playing field on one side, it re-enters it on the other side. And if we apply the same concept to light rays, we can kind of see more copies of the playing field behind its borders. Yeah, I'll probably go into more technical details behind the ray tracing here in another video. But yeah, for now let's just see what our game currently looks like. So yeah, there probably isn't too much to say about the gameplay itself. You're just a snake in a 3D looped space, and your goal is to collect as many of these yellow cubes as possible without colliding with anything. Yeah, the most notable difference to the original game is probably just that here you can move freely in all directions and not just straight up or straight down, because we just found that to be way less disorienting than being only able to turn in right angles. And also, another difference is that you can actually collide with the grid here, because the game would have been pretty easy otherwise, because you could have just gone straight in one direction all the time. We've also implemented a few other things, like other game mods and local multiplayer, but I think the most outstanding feature of the game overall is probably the graphics, because as I've said, the whole idea behind this was mainly about applying ray tracing to Snake. Right now it doesn't look too special of course, but we've implemented a few different graphic effects that can be activated here in the settings. So for example, as you might have already noticed, we've implemented reflections. That's actually not that hard to do using ray tracing, but it makes for a really cool visual effect. Or another effect which I personally find quite interesting is the so-called acid effect, as we've called it, which basically just distorts objects when they appear closer to other objects. And makes colors kind of flow around them. So yeah, that looks pretty cool. Now, I don't want to go into too much detail about these effects, but yeah, if you want to try this out yourself, we've actually uploaded the whole game to GitHub and made it open source. So yeah, there you can download it as a runnable jar file and play it yourself, or you can even download the source code and take a look at how we've built that, if you're curious about how that works. The link for that is of course in video description. One final thing to note here is that this can actually run quite slow without a decent graphics card, sadly, since ray tracing is generally quite GPU intensive. To work around that, we've also had an option to change the resolution here in the settings, so we can at least play on lower resolution, but with kind of normal FPS. And we've also added the ability to take high resolution screenshots of the game, but that does currently a little unstable. But yeah, that's pretty much all I wanted to show you in this video. As I've said, the link to the GitHub repository is in the description, so check that out if you want. And yeah, it would be pretty cool if you could get some feedback on that. And yeah, besides that, thank you for watching, and bye.